A little rain couldn't dampen the spirits of the hundreds of hockey fans who took part in the Rogers hometown hockey stop in Whitby. The city nestled north of Lake Ontario has notable connections to some of the game's most notorious names, such as Adam Foote, James Neal, Joe Nieuwendyk, Gary Roberts, and that's just to name a few. And another name of note was signing autographs and meeting fans. With a smile on his face, Leafs forward Zach Hyman didn't have the winter blues.
It's awesome, you know, people braved the elements. It was a rainy day, but it didn't stop fans from coming out and experiencing it. So I want to thank everybody for coming out. It was an awesome day, and Whitby's a great town, so happy to be here.
Ron has discussed Canada's favorite pastime with all of the greats, Wayne Gretzky, Scotty Bowman, and the list goes on. But it's a Whitby Dunlops legend who's in Ron's top two for most intriguing hockey minds.
The ones I found most interesting were Harry Sinden and Bobby Clark. Bobby had a really great mind for when a player is washed up and a few other neat things about sort of the primal parts of the game. Harry was the most creative guy. So another member of that Dunlop team was Bob Adderley, became mayor here for years and years. And I just think, you know, that tradition of giving to the game, which Harry did as obviously coach of 72 Summit Series, which I now see with Joe Nieuwendyk and Gary Roberts and the Primeau boys, Wayne and Keith. They've all somehow become great educators in addition to being great hockey players. So really nice to represent Whitby.
The scrappier side of Whitby are brothers Wayne and Keith Primeau. And as Tara found out, we may not have been treated to this NHL bout of brotherly love if it wasn't for their parents.
The nicest thing about this job is just understanding people's roots and how much Whitby meant to them. My favorite story is the fact that Mike Primeau, their dad, who's in the Whitby Sports Hall of Fame because he's such a storied coach, actually only got into coaching because their mom, Peggy, signed him up. So he was reluctant. The kids started playing. She said, "You better start coaching." He said, "I don't think I really want to," and she signed him up anyway. So that kind of, you know, that's how history was written.
A new chapter in hockey history is being penned by a group of women you may not first expect to hit the ice.
There was a game at the Iroquois Center on Saturday night between the Whitby AA Wolves midget team, the girls team, and the Lebanese national women's team, which is in its infancy. The goal is to meet IIHF status and ultimately get to the Olympics. So they have this fantastic group of girls from 14 to in their 30s. They don't get much time to play together, but they were invited by the Whitby Wolves and they got to play an exhibition game Saturday night. And it was very evenly matched, you know, for a team that obviously hasn't had a lot of time to practice together. They looked really competitive.
Surrounding the Rogers hometown hockey celebration saw the Florida Panthers host the Montreal Canadiens. And all the way down in Sunrise, Florida, finding ties to Whitby wasn't too tall of an order. Unless you measure the love a 6'5" Memorial Cup champion has for his time spent in the Durham region.
Josh, hometown hockey out of Whitby, Ontario, a community where you spent some time as a junior hockey player. Tell me how that community shaped you as a man and as a hockey player.
Well, you know, it's a great community. I love my time spent there in the Whitby Oshawa area. My first 3 years building, actually, I was in Whitby. So, but yeah, you know, it's a great town, great people, and yeah, I love my time that I spent there.
Every day is Saturday night, but I can't wait for Sunday morning. Raised in Whitby, that hook by chaos epitomizes the Rogers hometown hockey stop in Whitby. Hockey nights in Canada always feel like a Saturday, but in the show's sixth season, this Sunday in Whitby was well worth the wait.